Fun begins.
To the point, formative, entertaining, and protecting the Second Amendment. Welcome back to Elster's Rifles Reloading. And I am back out here at the private range. And I think I got almost everything set up. I still got a few things I got to tweak out, but I figured I'd take you guys on a little tour on the private range here. I'm sure some of you guys have already seen this. We got the big old monster electrical spool. We got sitting on some cinder blocks. We got this nice and level. And the best part is we got this for free. And made this quick little bench platform here to sit on out of an old deck we had laying around. And I figured I'd show you at 25, 50, 75, 100, and we even stretched the legs out clear to 200 yards. We might have to clear some brush, but I figured I'd take you guys on a quick little tour of what I did. Now, just be upfront and honest with you guys, these steel gong packages with the rubber strapping and hardware was supplied to me from shootingtargets7.com. So if you happen to be interested in what I did here, I'll have a link in the description box below, and you can click on that link and it'll give you further information on these particular products. Well, enough of the BS talk here. Let me take you on a quick little tour. All right, so I set up a station here at 25 yards, one at 50, one at 75, and then we got a whole slew of gongs and a backer board to staple up paper targets at 100. And then right between these two trees, we're gonna stretch it out clear to 200. So let's move down to 25 yard and I'll show you what's going on. Now I staggered these off to the side here. This is at 25 yards. And what's really nice about this is I can just slide this right off and I can move this down to, for example, say 50 yards. So we're here at 50 yards and 75 yards. Now, let me show you what at least I did in regards to putting in these studded T-posts. What works best for me, I think, is I have these exactly 22 inches apart. You can notice when I drived in these studded T-posts, obviously they're straight up and level and plumb. I used a level for that to make sure of that. And then I also cocked these out a little bit. You can notice they're not exactly in line with each other. You can notice I put these off at a slight angle. And I think that works best in regards to getting good tension on these studded T-post clips in order to attach the rubber strapping to the T-posts. And you could still slide these off really nice and they can adjust really easy. And for example, if you want to move this to 50, 75 yards in my example, or if you want to swap this out with a different style gong. It's really, really easy. Easy to level out, obviously, so you don't have to get these exactly the same height. You just go to a different, you know, studded T-post height on these posts itself. Then in regards to the actual hardware itself, and let me zoom in here for you guys. Now, when it comes to the hardware, it comes with a specific hardware package. And you're going to want to do it this way in regards to making sure that the gong angles down a little bit. You don't want this, you know, straight up like this. You want to angle down. Obviously, that way, when you hit this or the bullet impacts the gong, it directs that spray of the shrapnel more towards the ground. And in order to make sure that happens, ShootingTarget7.com sells this hardware package with these gongs. And the correct order for this, and I called ShootingTarget7.com to make sure of this, is you want to use the carriage bolts, not the hex style bolts, but the carriage bolts with the gong, and then use the split lock washer next, the thin nut, and tighten that down. And that will create tension against this lock washer so this carriage bolt doesn't spin. And then right after that, you're going to want to use the lock style nut. And then after that is the washer. Put on the rubber strapping. And then after that is another washer and another lock style nut. And what that does is it just pushes that gong out a little bit, and obviously gravity does its thing and angles that off at a nice directional angle. So when you hit this with your bullet, it directs that shrapnel down to the ground. All right, so let's check out the stations at 50, 75, and we'll see what's going on at 100.
Here we're at 50 yards, 75.
Now you can see here at 100 yards, I pretty much did the exact same thing, but obviously with a 12-inch gong, and that's going to be awesome. I can't wait to beat this thing up. Well, I'm sharing one of these studded T-posts with this 1-inch conduit pipe. You should be able to purchase this 1-inch conduit pipe pretty much at any local hardware store, Lowe's, Home Depot. I got this from Menards. And also these U-shaped bolts here, which I'm about to go over here in a little bit, I got all that at the local hardware store. So this should be something that you should easily pick up at, say, Home Depot, Lowe's, Menards, True Value. They should have that. So let's take you around the side here. And ShootingTarget7.com actually supplies what they call these super hangers. And they're 1/4 inch thick, AR500, so they can take a direct impact. And you can put any size gong on these. And you just spin this hexagonal nut washer, depending on the thickness of the plate you're using and the style type of gong that you're using, you just spin this around till it runs tight on the back like this, and then you tighten this home, and this will not come off. That is not going anywhere, and it's pretty darn slick. And what I did is I just got some U-shaped bolts, and I'll splice in a picture of those here. I got these from Menards, and this picture should show the price and SKU number if you do have a local Menards close to you. But these work pretty darn cool. And I just put one of these on each side just so this doesn't slide back and forth. And I did the same thing with another super hanger, but with a 4-inch gong and two more total U-shaped bolts. And these U-shaped bolts come with a hex nut, but I purchased some additional lock style nuts to make sure that these don't back off. And I can't wait to bang this up. This should be pretty slick. And if this pipe happens to get damaged, these are really inexpensive. You just pick these up at your local hardware or Lowe's, Home Depot, Menards, you name it, for a few bucks. Not that expensive to replace. And you can see I attached this 1-inch conduit pipe to the studded T-post with some larger U-shaped bolts, which I also we'll splice in a picture in the video right now, and that should show the price and the SKU number, at least from Menards. And these come with two nuts, but you can see I purchased two additional lock style nuts to make sure that these don't back off. And this is really, really rigged. I don't expect this becoming loose at all, but who knows? And you guys are about to see that in my future videos. and plan on coming out here tomorrow and banging this back up with the tail end of this video. And I don't know, I'm really excited and I can't wait to try this out. Let's go down and show you the 200 yard mark and then we'll go from there. Now before we head down to the 200 yard mark, I can easily slide this 12 inch gong off the 100 yard position here, or maybe even the 8-inch gong that I have set up at 25 yards and move it down to 200.
So we do have some trees and some brush here that we need to take out in order to make sure that the bullet doesn't strike that. But you can see I got two more studded T-posts here at 200 yards. It's actually a little bit less than that. It's like about 100, I think it's 193 yards. You can see we got our
cabin in the sky here. We're deer hunting. And two more studded T-posts here, pretty much at 200 yards, and it should have a direct line of sight once we remove some of this brush. Well, I've been out here all day installing this stuff, and it's time for me to get some dinner. So I'll see you guys on the flip side.
So let me fast forward this till tomorrow.
Okay, so the first runner-up here is the PSA AR-47. It has a 10.5-inch barrel and 7.62x39. And I am shooting just inexpensive hollow point Wolf steel case ammunition, 7.62x39. And I'm rocking the Vortex Strike Eagle 1-8 SFP scope. And this should be a lot of fun, especially with a 10.5-inch AR pistol and using really inexpensive Wolf steel case ammunition that I can usually get for roughly shipped about $3.90 per 20 round box. So I got 10 rounds loaded up here and I'm gonna start out with one shot at 25 yards in the 8-inch gong. And then I'm gonna try and use the remaining 9 to get through the 50 yard gong or know your limits target from 8 to 2-inch in increments of 1-inch gong increments. Try my best to get through that without missing with 10 rounds. And then after that, I am gonna quick load up 10 more rounds. And I'm gonna first start out with a 5-round shot group on paper at 100 yards and one hit on the 12-inch gong and hopefully have enough to hit the 4- and 2-inch spinners there on the permanent super hangers from shootingtarget7.com. So this should be interesting. Let's see if I can get all the way through this and see how fast I can do it. I'm not gonna go extremely fast, but I'm gonna try to pick up the pace here a little bit. So with that said, I got 10 rounds loaded up and let's see what we can do here. So let me get my hearing protection on. All right, here we go. So 10 rounds. Any marks? Get set, go. Oh, I missed on the 2-inch. All right, nailed it. I think I got a couple left, so I'm gonna go back on the 8-inch at 50 yards. Done. Quick load up 10.
And after this 10, I'm heading down to a 5-shot group on paper at 100 yards.
All right, 5-shot group on paper, 100 yards. Center diamond. All right, that should be 5. 12-inch gong. 4-inch gong. And 2-inch gong. Nailed it. I got a few left. I'm gonna go back on the 12 inch. That's all she wrote, my friends. Let's go down and see how we did. All right. So not bad at 100 yards. It's pretty dead center, at least for inexpensive Wolf ammunition. You know, for a quick 5-shot group, I wouldn't say that's the best, but I was not exactly taking my time. But for inexpensive 7.62 by 39 ammo, that's pretty darn good. So I'd say that's roughly about 2 minutes of angle, maybe about 2 1/4. And as for the spinners, looks like we nailed those too, and that looks really, really awesome. All right, next up on the block is the 6.5 Grendel PSA upper. All right, next up, the PSA 20 inch 6.5 Grendel stainless steel barrel. Just a quick go over this. I'm rocking the F-Cancer lower with a Hyperfire trigger. This is a 4-16 scope. I'm gonna start out on the 8X on the 25 and 50 yard, and then I'm gonna crank up the 16 at 100. So pretty much the same deal, one shot at 25 and the 8-inch gong. And I'm gonna move on to the Know Your Limits target here at 50 yards, work my way down. I got 10 shots to get to that. And then after that, 10 shots, I'm gonna quick load up. I'm gonna try and do it without removing cheek weld and remove them out of this plastic box here of ammo. And I'm gonna take 5 quick shots at 100 on the paper target, one shot on the 12 inch gong, and then try and hit the 4 and the 2. And try and do all that within 10 shots here. So let me get set up here. So I'm on the 8 power, starting off on that 8 inch gong. All right, here we go. And marks, get set, ready, go. Nice, going back on the 8 inch gong and the Know Your Limits. All right, loading up 10 without moving cheek weld. Oh, I got a stubborn one here. Damn, metal mags. This up to 16. I believe that was 5. 12 inch gong. 4 inch. Looks like I'm hitting a little low and left onto the 2 inch spinner. Nailed it. Nice. Go back on that 12 inch. Actually, I'm going to hit that 2 inch again. That was too much fun. Miss. Miss. That's it. Man, that's a lot of fun. Let's move on to the 22LR Ruger Precision Rifle. All right. So yeah, I think I was hitting a little low into the left. Let's see with this 5-shot group. I'm actually amazed it's not a little bit better than that. It's like it's right about 2 minutes of angle. And I think, yeah, definitely I was hitting a little low into the left. Ooh, it looks like That took a little bit of a chunk off that 2-inch at 100 yards with that 6.5, so interesting. All right, next up on the block is the Ruger Precision Rimfire 22LR. All right, so here we go. Ruger Precision Rimfire 22LR. Got 10 rounds loaded up. Got this set at a 50 yard, at least where I shoot my parallax at 50 yards, just to say. Start out at that 25 yard gong. Let's see how centered I can get this. So that's pretty much as center as it's gonna get. All right, moving on to the 50 yard Know Your Limits rimfire. All right, got the first one. We've got slow down, see where I'm hitting on that. It's pretty center, a little left. Check that one too. That one is pretty darn center too, so let's keep on going. We're doing slight holdovers between the 25, 15, and obviously when I go to 100, I'll definitely have to do a strong holdover. It's a little left, be centered. And it's picking up a little bit. It definitely plays a factor in this 22LR world. That was definitely left. And adjust right, 1/4 minute of angle. That one's a little low. I think I'm definitely hitting a little low, 1/4 minute of angle adjustment up. All right. That one looks pretty darn center, so that looks good. Okay, so these are getting pretty hard to see in this shade. Got it. All right, 1/4 inch. Nailed it. Nice. Let's go for that 1/4 inch again. See if I can hit it twice. I think I got one round left. Unstoppable. And I think that's it. I'm going to make sure on that 2-inch. Yep, that's it. Slowed up another 10. Moved down to 100. And I'm definitely going to do a strong holdover on that. So let's load up 10. I'm actually going to start out in that 12-inch gong, see where I'm hitting. And then I'm going to do a 5-shot group on that paper. All right. 10 loaded up, starting out on the 12-inch gong. Adjusting my parallax to what I typically shoot it at, 100. All right, doing a holdover, considerable holdover. See, that's pretty darn good. I think I need to go left just a little bit. All right, middle diamond, paper target. 5 shots. All right, fifth shot here. All right, so it looks like I'm, it's still hard to make out at 100 yards. I think I'm shooting a little high in the right, I think, but we're moving on to the 4-inch gong, 4-inch spinner. Definitely see where I'm hitting on this. Yep, definitely high and to the right. So I'm gonna hold low and left here just a little bit on that 2-inch gong. Nailed it. Nice. Looks like it's a little high and to the left. I was doing a little bit of a slight hold low and left. So let me adjust for that. I think I got one round left. Nailed it. Nice. I think that's it. Let me try once more. I don't know if I hit that. This has got to be the last round. Yep, that's it. Let's go down and see how we did. Yeah, this 25 yard is pretty much as center as it's gonna get. That looks really good. All right, let me hit pause here. And yeah, that was really impressive. Made it all the way through at 50 yards. Hit that quarter inch twice. And that looks really impressive too. So let's head down to 100 yards. Here's what that 5-shot group looks like. All right, hit pause. So yeah, on the plate, I was a little high and to the right. And hey, that's not bad for 5 shots. Look, one went way off, and it definitely could be a mischarge on that one round. But to have 4 in roughly 1 minute of angle, that looks pretty darn good. I'd say that's pretty impressive. As for the 4-inch gong, I noticed I was hitting a little high and to the right. So I adjusted for that, and it looks like these are just on the edge of the circle. So yeah, it'd be a real toss-up if I, this one definitely could have been off. This one would have been right on the edge. But yeah, for doing holdovers, I would say that's pretty darn good, especially for CCI standard velocity. Well, I would say that was more than fun. You know, just really inexpensive plinking at your private range, especially like a beautiful day like today in Wisconsin. You know, with the Ruger Precision Rimfire 22LR, we're just shooting really inexpensive CCI standard velocity ammunition. I think I hooked up before this whole COVID mess for roughly $85, $90 shipped for 2,000 rounds. It's just dirt cheap. With the 6.5 Grendel, the PSA with a 20-inch barrel, we're just shooting inexpensive Wolf full metal jacket, 100 grain. I think I got this, I think it was $135 for 500 rounds shipped. And with the PSA AR-47, 7.62 by 39, with a really inexpensive hollow point Wolf 7.62 by 39 steel case ammunition. I believe I got 1,000 of that shipped for roughly $190. So just something you don't have to reload for. I really enjoy that. Just coming out and having a good time, especially with these ShootingTarget7.com target system. Now we have the permanent gongs and the permanent spinners set up at 100 yards. And you're eventually going to see this at 200 yards. We still need to get that berm pile behind those two posts. And then obviously we got the portable Know Your Limits targets, the Rimfire edition, and then obviously the Centerfire edition, which is about to debut here soon, roughly in the next week or two. I believe it's going to be, don't hold this to me, but preliminary price, $350 shipped for the 3/8 AR-500 gongs, and for the half inch, it's going to be roughly $400 to $450. That's not set in stone, so that can definitely change. And I just want to be straight up honest with you guys. These targets all of these targets, including the permanent gongs here with the strapping and the super hangers, was all sent to me from shootingtargets7.com. So I just want to be straight up honest with you guys and clear with that. But if you are interested in these target systems, check out the description box below, and I'll have a link that will take you to shootingtargets7.com for more information if you want to purchase it yourself. Well, I think this was more than successful and tons of fun. And hopefully this inspires you to take you and your family out to the range and spread that knowledge of the Second Amendment. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Hit that notification bell. Become a Patreon, and I will see you guys in the next video.